everyone, Jason here, digital marketing consultant, and in this sales funnel creation guide, you're going to learn everything you need to know click by click to put together your sales funnel using WordPress, Thrive Themes, and then we'll go through some shopping cart options as well as how to put together your membership website on WordPress. So make sure you check out the timestamp table of contents in the description, along with some other helpful videos that take a deeper dive into putting together these specific elements. The goal of this particular video is to show you the whole nine yards, everything you need to do, but a brief overview. So we're not going to take a deep dive because that would be like 5 or 6 hours and nobody has that kind of time. So let's go ahead, jump right in. The very first thing I want to talk about is the type of sales funnel we'll be putting together today. So we're going to be putting together something called a video sales letter. So you're going to have a landing page that offers a free training or webinar video presentation. The page right after that will be your video sales letter. So it will be a combination of content and of course sales to whatever your product or service is. We'll go through some checkout options because there are a lot. So we're not going to take a deep dive into collecting payments. And then I'll show you how to use something called Thrive Apprentice to deliver your digital courses. And we're going to be using Thrive Architect to actually build our pages. So with that, let's go ahead and dive into my screen and I'll show you what you need to have before you jump into putting together all these pages. Now, I highly recommend putting together a document where you have all of your sales copy done. So as you can see here, I have all of the copy for my landing page. I have all the information I need for my sales page. Of course, it's just a Vimeo link because it's a video sales letter. And then all the information I need for my checkout. And of course, I have a couple emails from my email sequence, although I'm missing the last three. So it's a lot easier to build stuff when you already have all of your copy and images ready to go in one place. So with that, let's go ahead and jump into creating the landing page. So here's an example of what the final landing page will look like. And I'll show you how to use Thrive Architect when we build our sales page from scratch. But a couple things to note here. You'll notice this is a very, very basic design. This is as much work as you need to put in when you're just starting with your sales funnel. There are a lot of templates inside of Thrive Themes, and if you're going to be using GetResponse or ClickFunnels or Kartra or InstaPage, lead pages, whatever, you need just a headline, a button so they can get to the next page, and you can collect their email, and bullet points. That's it. That's all we need. We don't need to get any more fancy than that. So I'm gonna go ahead and edit with Thrive Architect so I can show you how to put this together. Now, the reason I like Thrive Architect, it is a what you see what is what you get editor. So you can see if I click up here and start typing, the text comes right in. And all we need is our headline. You can edit all of these individual elements. And if you want to add something, there are a lot of pre-done things over here. Although when you're putting together your landing page, really all you need is your bullet points, your headline, and a couple of buttons. So I'm not gonna take a super deep dive into how to build this like click by click. There'll be a link in the description to how to put together a landing page completely from scratch. I used one of their templates to put together this particular page. And so all I did was in my document here, I just copied and pasted all of the text that I already had. So I highly, highly recommend you write out all of your copy before you start looking into building your actual pages. It's going to save you a tremendous amount of time. So let's talk about the button, because the button is where you're going to be able to make sure that you collect their email information and you send them on to the next step of the process. So here, if you click on the button, we'll scroll down and we'll go to animation and action. And you'll see here that there's something called a Thrive Leads box popping up. So there's a plugin that also comes from Thrive called Thrive Leads. And all you do is create the actual pop-up that shows up for them to enter their name and email. So I'm going to go ahead and edit this one so you can see what the interface looks like. Again, it's very simple, drag and drop. We'll click on Edit Design. And just like the landing page builder, it's very easy to edit your text and of course add elements if you want by coming over here and clicking to add elements. However, for your pop-up, this is as complex as it needs to be. Now you'll actually be able to connect to a lot of different autoresponders. So if you come over here to API, you see I have MailChimp and I also have ConvertKit set up. So I'll show you both MailChimp and ConvertKit and how these work. So this particular one is already set up using ConvertKit. And once you have it connected, all you need to do is come and click and say which list you want people to be added to. And if you want any tags, you can set up what the form fields are going to be. Typically, I just do name and email because I want to maximize the number of people that actually opt in. And of course, the final step is the post action page for the opt-in. So in this particular instance, it will be the URL of our sales letter, right? And then we can go ahead and click save and we're all good to go. So back to our landing page, that's everything that went behind defining what the pop-up is going to be. Now let's go ahead and take a deeper dive into how to actually build a page from scratch and going through the templates by putting together our video sales letter page, because I haven't put that together yet. So inside of your Word dashboard, you'll just go to pages and click add new. You'll go ahead and give it a name and then click edit with Thrive Architect. So we can use the architect page builder instead of the default WordPress builder. And now it's time to choose a template. So we'll go ahead and click to change the template here. And instead of scrolling through all the templates they have, let's just go ahead and look for a sales page template that we can easily modify. So I'll click on sales page and then scroll down to see if I can find a template that I want to use. Of course, we're doing a video, so I'm looking at these ones that have videos. I'm gonna keep it real basic, click on this one and click choose template, and it will go ahead and load. So while it's loading, I'm gonna come back here and I know I'm going to need this guy because that's the URL of my actual sales letter. And so to change that, I'll go ahead and click on the video. I'll click on Vimeo for the source, and then I'll just drop that right in there and click save work. And now there's my actual Vimeo video for there. So now I need to get my headline. So this is gonna be my headline. And I just can select all, paste that in. I actually still want this to be centered, so I'll do that. YouTube growth training. That looks better. I don't actually want a subheadline, but if I did, I could do something like this to give it a nice little subheadline. And let's say I don't like the spacing in between these two. So I want to bring this, all of this up. So I can go ahead and click on the actual text element, and then I can click on layout and position and click and drag it like this so that there's more space, or click and drag it the other way so there's less space. So I'm gonna do minus 25, and then I want the video to actually be a little lower. So let's go ahead and move the video down a little bit like that. Okay, there we go, OCD-ness all set. And then we can come down here. Of course, we can edit the disclaimer and things if you need that. Typically, I remove all of those links on the actual sales page, but I definitely make sure they're on the landing page so I'm compliant with whatever traffic source I'm using, because 9.9 out of 10 times, you need to have these types of links on your actual landing page when you're driving traffic, but not so much on your sales page. You really want there to just be one button on your sales page, and that is, of course, to buy. So I'm going to go ahead and remove this bottom section here. And the only thing left would be to format this button so that it goes to our shopping cart. But for now, I'm going to leave it and go ahead and pre-do the mobile preview to make sure that this is going to be formatted correctly if someone goes to the page on mobile. So to do that, all we have to do is come down here to the little preview bar and click to see what it looks like on a tablet. Most of the time, the tablet does a pretty good job. It's mobile where you really need to pay attention. You can see here that adding that space there made it look a little funny on mobile. So we'll go ahead and bring that up, and then we'll definitely want to bring the font size way down so it doesn't look like this. So bring that up here. And then for our button, let's go ahead and add a little bit of spacing so it's a little easier to read. And we better modify this to say, yes, I want to grow my YouTube channel. Perfect, going back to desktop to make sure it all looks good. Awesome, so here is our sales page, right? This is all we need for our sales page. I'm going to go ahead and save work and now preview. And here is our final sales page. So we have our headline, subheadline, the actual video, so you can click play and it'll start playing. And then of course we have our button that actually isn't doing anything yet. So before we actually dive into the different shopping cart options, I wanna walk you through what it looks like setting up your follow-up sequence via MailChimp and ConvertKit. So at this point, we've put together your landing page and your sales page. So that does it for everything you need to put together on your WordPress site using Thrive Apprentice. So now it's time to look at your email sequence, because it's important that we follow up with people, and then your different shopping cart options. So first, let's take a look at your email options. The two I currently recommend are ConvertKit and MailChimp. So if you're on a tight budget, MailChimp is great because you can start for free, and ConvertKit gives you a lot more visualization and automation features if you have the budget to spend $20 to $50 a month for your email autoresponder. Now, in both cases, Thrive is going to work with them, and most other page builders on WordPress, if you decide not to go with Thrive Apprentice, will also work with them. So let's go ahead and take a look at my ConvertKit account so you can see what an email automation sequence might look like for a basic video sales funnel just like this one. So inside of my ConvertKit account, you can see I'm under automations, and I'm going to click on Tube Machine Webinar. So all we have to do is essentially set up a rule saying, okay, how does this sequence start? In this particular instance, when we put together our Thrive lead box, you saw that we told ConvertKit to add people to a particular email list. Now, since ConvertKit is all one giant email list, it's technically a form, but it's just a different way that ConvertKit labels stuff, so it works with other software. So essentially here, what I did is I clicked on plus, and I say, hey, you know what? Every time someone signs up for the YouTube webinar, I want you to add them to this sequence. So I go ahead and click on add event. Obviously, these are the exact two events. And then the next step would be, hey, you know what? When they sign up, let's go ahead and give them this particular email sequence. So I can click on email sequence, create or search. You can see I already have an email sequence set up for this, and I can click on that. So now you can see that whenever someone opts in for the webinar, they'll automatically be added to this sequence. And you can modify your sequences in the sequences part of ConvertKit. So we'll click on this, we can click on add a new sequence, or I can click into here, and you'll be able to see all of the emails that go out to people once they've entered their name and email to actually view the video sales letter. And you can see these are all of the emails here. Now ConvertKit is plain text, but that's something that doesn't really bother me because plain text emails tend to actually hit the inbox a lot more than really fancy design newsletters, and they're just a lot more personal. And so as you can see here, this is email number 3. This is the exact same text that's in my document for email number 3 right here. And this is why it's so important to have everything pre-written, so you're just copying and pasting when you're trying to put all of this together, because there's definitely something is going to go wrong. Something always goes wrong when you're trying to put all this together. So definitely having your copy already written is going to save you a lot of time. And of course, I can add as many sequences as I want, and I can also go back to my automation and set it up so that when they do purchase the actual course that's on the back end, they'll be removed from the sequence, or if they've spent a certain amount of time and they haven't done anything, they'll be removed from the sequence. And of course, that's an extremely brief overview of what you would do with your email marketing and automation. So I highly recommend you check out ConvertKit. There's an affiliate link in the description to both Thrive Apprentice and ConvertKit so you can learn more, along with a playlist that compares ConvertKit to MailChimp so you know which one is right for you. Because if it doesn't make sense to pay for ConvertKit, MailChimp does give you a ton of options for free. Now, the final part of putting together your sales funnel is, of course, your shopping cart and your membership site. So for your shopping cart, I recommend you check out something like MemberMouse, MemberPress, ThriveCart, or Wave Accounting. So the last one is the one I'm going to show you here, Wave Accounting, because it's free. Now, it doesn't allow you to do fancy upsells and downsells, but it does allow you to take payments, and it's 100% free option. All those other ones are paid and involve a hefty one-time fee or a monthly fee in order to continue to work. So here you can see Wave Accounting is very simple. It gives you this nice plain page where they can enter their payment information and then just pay you. And then you can send them an email with whatever the access is to their membership website or whatever the next steps of doing services with you. So this page you're looking at right here would be linked directly from your sales page here. So when someone clicks, yes, I want to grow my channel, they would be taken to this checkout. So that's the simplest and fastest way to get up and running. putting together this page in Wave Accounting literally takes 15 minutes, and it is 100% free software. Now, the final step in our process, of course, if you're delivering a digital course, would be where the heck do you deliver your digital course? And I highly recommend you check out something called Thrive Apprentice. It is a WordPress plugin that's part of the Thrive suite, and it's very easy to put together your membership website. So I'll briefly show you how to do that. So here's a preview of what it actually looks like. You'll be able to put a welcome video, and then they'll be able to click through to all of their different trainings and modules. So I'll just click on this one. And this is a very basic site, but this is all you really have to do to put together a good looking membership website. You can see we have the training video up top, and then we have a couple of tabs for their downloads and additional information. And to put this together in the back end, this is what the back end looks like. You have Thrive Apprentice, you can preview your index. So if you have multiple courses, you can actually have an index page where people can see all the courses that they purchased from you. So that's great if you plan on making more than one product. And something I really like about this is as you put together these modules, they don't clog up the pages on your site. So all of the modules you put together inside of Thrive Apprentice aren't going to show up in your page preview. It's something that drove us nuts when using something like OptimizePress, where you would see every single membership page and you'd have like 20 or 30 pages of listings of pages when you're trying to find your stuff inside of WordPress, whereas this, it's all inside of Thrive Apprentice and it keeps your actual WordPress page listings nice and clean. So here's a quick overview of what it looks like when you have multiple programs. And of course, you can set this up so people can either see this when they're not logged in and then they click and they go to your landing page or your sales page, or you can just lock out this entire thing so that nobody sees it unless they opt in. So I hope you got some value out of this video. I know that it was a ton of information and we went click by click in some places and kind of glossed over some other ones. And really the point is to just show you the whole process of putting this together and what is possible with putting all of this together and the different options that you have. So please comment below with your questions. I'm inevitably missed something and I'm always looking to improve the content. And of course, more sales funnel trainings are along the way as I learn what's going to be most helpful to you. So make sure you comment below with your questions and suggestions for future walkthroughs and click-by-click tutorials. So go ahead and hit that like button and subscribe for more digital marketing tactics and strategies, deep dives just like this one. And until the next video, keep building the business you love.